Hey YouTube, Death Scouter making another video, and today we're going to be updating the software code for our Uconnect on our factory radios and our Jeep JKs. So to find out whether or not you have the latest code, you're going to go up here to www.driveuconnect.com, and once you're there, you're going to go to the support pull down menu and software update. All right. And then it's going to ask you for your VIN number, which you can locate in two places on your vehicle, the metal plate on your dash that you can see by looking in through the windshield, or if you open up your driver's door, there's a couple of factory installed tags right there, and it will include your VIN number. So type your full VIN number in and click the check for updates button, and it will tell you whether or not you have an update available. And if so, you just go ahead and follow the button to get started. And there's two ways to download the code and put it onto your vehicle. You can download a piece of software called a download manager, and there's a couple different companies that make download managers. Or the easiest way is to just download it directly here with option number 2 and just download it directly to your hard drive and click there and click the download update, and you'll see that this long zip file is ready to download, and you click OK and it will download to your download directory wherever that may be. Now this is a zip file. The other thing that you're going to need to pull off this is a USB memory drive or a flash stick or memory stick, whatever you want to call those. And I have found that if you try to use too big of a memory stick, at least in this particular case, my car couldn't read it. So I actually found a memory stick that was much smaller in size, and it worked just fine. You'll see that later on in the video, because I'm actually shooting this part after I've done the upgrade. So once you've downloaded this zip file, the other thing you need to do is now take your memory stick and insert it into one of your USB ports in your computer. Okay, once it's downloaded, because I have a WinZip utility installed, I'm just going to double click the file, and you'll notice that it opens up my WinZip utility for me, and it asks what I want to do with this file, and I'm going to say unzip these files to a folder that I choose. Okay, so I'll click that, and it wants to know where I'm going to put it, and I'm going to just choose my flash drive and say unzip and replace the file because it already is there. And now what I have, okay, so it's done, it's complete, and if I open up my file explorer and I take a look at my F drive, you'll see that what I've got now on my flash drive, my memory stick, is a file that's called uconnect.upn. And now we can take this flash drive and take it out and install it into the what's called the remote USB port of the vehicle and initiate the software update through the Uconnect voice interface with the Jeep. So let's go do that. Okay, so we're sitting out here in the Jeep, and I'm going to go ahead and hit this phone button, and I'm going to check and see what version of code is currently installed for Uconnect.
Paul's iPhone
is connected. Uconnect phone ready.
Setup, software update.
Please attach USB mass storage device with update file to system connector and try again.
Okay, so there it's showing you the version of code that we have. 63.3.5. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take the USB stick that we created on our PC, and we're going to bring it out here. We're going to plug it into what's called the remote USB port, which here is our console. Let me back up so you can see this, and open up the console and look in here on the side, and there it is, hidden here, tucked away. I didn't even know it was there until I went looking for this. So let's go ahead and plug in our USB stick, and it's firmly connected, and now we're going to apply the software update. car is turned on or the key is turned forward. Power needs to be on for this. Do not interrupt the power in any way while this process is happening. And let's try it again.
Paul's iPhone
is connected. Uconnect phone ready.
Setup, software update.
Please attach USB mass storage device with update file to system connector and try again.
I just went ahead and plugged in my USB stick here in the console. All right, so here is the port that they call this the remote USB port. So let's try this again. Let's hit the phone button.
Uconnect phone ready.
Setup, software update.
Starting software update process. Please wait.
Okay, so we should start hearing maybe 10 minutes worth of beeps. So here you see that. You get the message right there that this is being done. Rumor has it that on this version of this year of Jeep, this might be a 10-minute process. I want to point out something that this USB stick is, I think, 10 gig. And it's only a 4 meg file sitting on there. I tried this once before with a much larger USB stick, and it would not be read. So I was afraid that a 2013 Jeep, it's now 2018, so it's technically a 5-year-old vehicle already. Oh, wow, didn't realize that. So, but a 5-year-old vehicle may not be able to see and read a memory stick of substantial size. So I went ahead and did a USB stick that was a lot smaller. And as you can see, it is working. Okay, so I'm going to continue the video. I pulled out my USB plug as soon as my radio went back to the off state. I'm going to do a verify now. Now remember, we were at 63.3.5 code when we started. So let's see where we are now.
Paul's iPhone
is connected. Uconnect phone ready.
Setup, software update.
Please attach USB mass storage device with update file to system connector and try again.
Okay, so we're now sitting at 63.3.8, which is not where we started. We started at 63.3.5. So this is how you perform a software update on Uconnect and then verify that it works afterwards. Hope this was a good video for you guys. Appreciate you guys checking out my Death Scouter channel. Subscribe for some other videos.